Hey everybody, shout out to our Reddit on, I'm sorry, our billiards on Reddit. I do another kind of a pool chat here with three racks. I'll start out on this one. Really good break, really easy layout here. Really any decent player should be out here, barring a stroke or some other medical emergency. It's basically just staying on the right side of the line. Really not much to talk about. I just want to basically some low right and spin off the rail and down, just staying above the four so you can either roll to the five, or where I'm at, actually some little bit of low right and stun over for the five on the side. And I actually had hoped to come down a little bit more where I'd be stunning over to shoot the six in the same pocket, but I didn't do it. So a couple things crossed my mind here. I was going to try to maybe draw back and shoot the six in the corner. But then I do have the angle where I could just roll forward as long as my speed's good. I don't go in the drink and then just roll the six in the other side. And then on the seven ball here, really anything's good. It'd be really difficult to screw this up. So really the main focus here is pocketing the ball and trying to get kind of as close to straight as possible. But this works all right here. Just getting a little bit of more bottom English. It's going to come off the rail and out. And then on this, some more bottom English. And since we're cutting the ball left, the bottom will just slide right. And we'll be shooting nine in the same hole. And nothing exciting on that one. Just basically making an easy lag, excuse me, an easy rack look easy, which is what you want to do. Now this rack wasn't quite as easy, especially the opening shot. So the one ball ends up, with some distance. And here where the three is, you really, when you make this, want to come off, side roll by the one off the other side and get as straight on the two as possible to roll up to the three. That would ideally be what you want. Didn't hit it great, hit it okay. Cue ball rolled pretty much. Barely far enough where I still had any kind of shot. Now, tough shot here, a little touchy inside English and kind of a slow roll, which I hate doing. See, I almost missed that. Actually, may not go on a diamond table, possibly. Did get myself a shot. Here we're coming straight up. It's just a speed control shot, which I did kind of poorly here. Really went about 4 or 5 inches too far. Really want to be cutting this four ball into the corner and rolling the two to the side. I'm sorry, the cue to the side rail. We were straight in on the five. Instead, where I was at, straight on the four, just roll up so the nine's out of the way. And just basically resigning to the fact you're going to be taking a cut on the six ball. Rather than doing anything crazy, like try to force the cue ball between the eight and the six, just kind of roll it in, take the cut. And here's another speed control shot. We're just going straight up the table. I'm just basically trying to roll the six in and not go too far. And this shot looks tough on camera, but it really isn't that bad. You just basically just focus on making the eight ball. And I'm hitting it with a touch inside, so it comes back down past the side pocket. And we're going to have a shot on the nine ball. But really on a thin cut like that, yeah, you're going to have a shot at the nine ball as long as you make the ball. Don't knock the crap out of him and get on the back rail or something. Now on the last rack here, got two balls down on the break, and this is another one that once you get past the first shot is pretty easy. So a lot of nine ball racks are. Now ideally here, I like the 3-4 combination. But again, you're shooting the two into the rail, or cue ball into the rail, and it's a speed control shot to get on that. And I was definitely trying to get on the 3-4 combination, and I overamped it a tad. And overran it. So now rather than taking some ridiculous back cut on the 4, I just plan on just shooting 3 past the 9. And something I'm looking at back here is basically the cue ball where it was going to travel. I just wanted to make totally sure I wasn't going to run into the four ball with the cue ball or somehow hit the eight and make the four. That would just be a disaster because of where the six ball is. If I make the three and the four in one shot, which on the camera doesn't even look possible, but down on the table, it was definitely something I was a little bit concerned about. So made sure I avoided the four ball. Otherwise, like I said, if you accidentally make the four, then you got either no shot or a ridiculous shot on the six. And this shot here got pretty lucky. I'm just trying to come back to the left of the six ball all the way to the back rail and back out. I did draw that far back intentionally. It's a lot easier to power draw a ball than it is to just draw it like 7 feet and stop. But I ran into the six ball and was fortunate that I hit the side of it and not dead square. And so I did wind up with a shot. And here's coming up table for the seven ball. And here's a shot that I like. I got inside of the line. And it's going to be, instead of trying to roll this or slow roll it or any kind of touchy shot, I like just firing this ball in with some low, left spin. And going all the way to the rail. And then the left spin takes you down into the shooting line on the eight ball. And actually hit this pretty good. I think this is just an easier shot to shoot with a little bit of pace. Then off the rail and the spin takes and back into the eight ball. And then from here, basically two stop signs. So did get fortunate there on two shots, but fortunately, was able to still get out, which is key to pool. If you do get lucky, capitalize on it. And anyway, I hope you guys enjoyed this, and that'll do it for this one, and we'll be back and do some more.